Nets. McCollum looking for some day late. Gets it to Jones. He'll fire. Splash! And we are tied.
That was a great set out of that timeout. Use Brandon Ingram as a decoy and let CJ be the one to initiate the offense.
Gilgeous-Alexander poked away, and he coughs it up. Here comes Ingram, full head of steam, extends, and he's put the Pelicans back in front. What a fascinating final 3.5 minutes this is going to be here in Oklahoma City. Number one seeded Thunder. Can they rise to the moment? Turnover again. Gilgeous-Alexander trying to get it to Dort, threw it into the bench.
Well, he's dealing with elite level defense. When you talk about Herb Jones and what he's able to do, he's strong and he's long, and he's having an impact on SGA.
Pelicans on a 9-1 run. This is going to be an illegal pick. Second time we've seen that call in the second half against the Pelicans. And it's on Herb Jones, his second.
Willie Green felt like he flopped, but that's a huge play here for the Pelicans.
Willie Green's Pelicans, most wins in a season in 15 years. 49 wins, number one road team in the league this season. And we are inside of 3 minutes. Here's Holmgren on the box, spinning fade. Too much. Nance skies for the rebound.
Another just unforced error there. Larry Nance Jr. got the rebound, but tosses it to Murphy when he was out of bounds.
No field goals, Greg, for Oklahoma City in 4 minutes. But they catch a break right here.
Yeah, just a little more patience there. That was a huge break for the Thunder here. They are reeling. Haven't really been able to create any good looks at the basket here down the stretch.
Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, catch and shoot three. Boy, misses badly. Jones knocked away. Holmgren. And then it's poked back. Who touched it last? Neither official can make the call, and Tony Brothers says jump.
Now, by rule, I think that's the right call, but.
And now Mark Daigneault, I believe, is going to challenge.
After review, the ruling on the floor is New Orleans ball. The ball was last touched by Holmgren of Oklahoma City. Because the play was changed from a jump ball to possession, Oklahoma City will retain their timeout and their ability to challenge, which makes the challenge successful.
Yeah, so they do charge the Thunder with a timeout. So they're down to their final timeout left. What a massive call that is, potentially. Nance rolling to the cup. Broken up inside. What a defensive recovery in tight by the Thunder. Oklahoma City, youngest number one seed in NBA playoff history. How do they handle this moment? Dort misses point blank.
Wow, both teams miss a point blank opportunity.
Final 2 minutes in regulation. Jones is fouled by Gilgeous-Alexander way out in the front court.
Yeah, you can live with that. You don't put him on the line. The question is, if you're Willie Green, I would think you'd want to attack offensively and not involve Lou Dort. And so now that you got Williams on McCollum, let's see if they initiate with him.
First in the last 2 minutes against the Thunder. Ingram leans into Dort, and this is going to be an offensive foul.
Yeah, that was a little surprising. Not that Brandon Ingram isn't a terrific offensive player, but listen, CJ McCollum's terrific offensively as well. You can see here, initiates with that left shoulder. And Lou Dort does a great job of selling it. But that's a situation where I would have liked to put the ball in McCollum's hands. I felt like he has a little bit more of an advantage offensively because of that matchup.
Look at the drought for the Thunder. No field goals in more than 5 minutes. Gilgeous-Alexander, money on the table, and he buries it. We are tied with 90 seconds on the clock.
That was a big time finish there.
Nance into the corner. This is Jones left open. In and out. Offensive rebound. Nance. McCollum misses badly. Jones keeps it alive. What a play by Jones. Errant pass. Loose ball. Murphy. Ingram rises. Way too much, and it's Nance again. Shot clock did not reset, so JTR blows the whistle. They're going to reset it to 12 seconds with 64 seconds left in regulation.
And this might be a time, if you're the Pelicans, or maybe if you're Willie Green, take a timeout. This is such an important possession. And you've gotten three offensive rebounds and didn't get a good look on either of them. But he's going to roll the dice with his young group.
Willie's got two timeouts, doesn't elect to take one here. Interesting. And here we go. It's McCollum. Pick and roll action. Nance inside, extends. Holmgren turns him back. Fifth block for the rookie sensation, Holmgren. And it's Williams against McCollum. Gilgeous-Alexander guarded by McCollum. Chisels into the paint, flicks it up and in, and contact.
And even on that possession, what did they do? They forced the switch to get Jones off of Gilgeous-Alexander, and he's able to take advantage of that matchup and convert there with contact.
25-year-old Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, who has led this franchise renaissance in Oklahoma City, can give the Thunder a three-point lead with 32.5 left. Or you want the glory at this level, this is the time of the game where you got to put your team on your back. And that's exactly what
Billy. And then at the last minute, when he saw Nance go for the layup, able to change direction and come up with the block.
What are the Pels turn here in dire need of a bucket? Yeah, here comes McCollum. Baseline fade, and he buries it. What a shot by McCollum. One-point game.
Yeah, and the advantage for the Pelicans, they have a timeout to give.
Dort gets it to Holmgren in the corner. About a two-second difference. Shot to game clock. As the whistle is blown against McCollum. Penalty situation and free throws for Chet Holmgren to try to push this back to a three-point lead.
Yeah, that's just big-time finish there by McCollum. And I really like the strategy by the Pelicans there. Go for the steal, be aggressive, and then try to make sure you don't foul the wrong person, meaning SGA.
21-year-old Chet Holmgren in his NBA playoff debut misses on the first. 79% free throw shooter during the regular season. First free throw attempts of the night for Holmgren. One of two. It's a two-point lead with 14 seconds left. Ingram, 5 of 17. CJ McCollum, 9 of 21. And here we go. Jones the inbounds to McCollum. 10 seconds. Pelicans are out of timeouts. McCollum against Wallace, poked away. 4 seconds. McCollum, the fake, the fire. No, and it's over. Oklahoma City survives and hold on to take game one against the Pelicans.